gossip does have some bad connotations, but I like gossip. And I think most people do, whether they admit it or not. But most people are very much interested in gossip. And I think of gossip as a way for kids to learn about history by using gossipy details about people from the past. It's a way to hook readers in and tell them the other things that you want them to know about these famous people, why they're so respected, what their accomplishments were. So I think of gossip as a good thing. I try to put a good spin on it. And I have been interested in gossip ever since I was little. One time in sixth grade, our assignment was to pick any word from the dictionary that we wanted to and write a research paper about it. And the word I picked was gossip. So I could tell you a lot about gossip and what it means throughout history. It's an interesting concept, and I like to think of it as a good hook too. We're all secretly People magazine readers at heart, even though we might not admit it. I do try to humanize the famous people from history, especially I would think in my Lives of books, which are all about the famous people, these icons from history, and what the neighbors thought of these famous people, which is just sort of a way of saying these are the very nosiest things that I could find out about each person, that they weren't marble busts that you see on a piano somewhere or in a library on the top shelf, old, dead, and moldy. These are real human beings with quirks and faults and interesting habits and different girlfriends and boyfriends and ways to spend their money and clothes and hair and underwear and little personality quirks and how they related to their children and their parents and just whatever I can find that makes them seem like real human beings. That's my goal. Well, one of the most interesting people that I've researched, they're all fascinating, but Beethoven had a lot of personality quirks and a lot of problems with his neighbors. Beethoven actually had to move about once a year because of so many complaints from his neighbors. He played his music in the middle of the night, the same thing over and over again, drove the neighbors crazy. Wasn't big on personal hygiene, really didn't care about clothes or his hair, keeping clean clothes. His friends, he did have friends because he was a very charismatic person, but they would try to help him out by, when he would fall asleep, they would take his old crusty clothes away and bring in a new suit of clothes for him to wear the next day. He'd put on the new clothes and would not notice that there had been a change. So just was not into his clothes. Kept food around his apartment till it got old and moldy and very smelly. Kept a pot by his piano so he didn't have to go far when he had to go to the bathroom.
Funding for AdLit.org is provided by the Anne B. and Thomas L. Friedman Family Foundation. For more information on adolescent literacy, please visit us online at www.adlit.org.